And please just look to me, not to the camera. Okay, great. So nice talking to you. You are one of the, I think, iconic characters of Star Wars, of the new episode.
Yeah.
So what kind of honor or feeling was it for you playing this part and being on the set with all these nice guys?
Oh, well, I mean, it was amazing. It's incredible. My first day of filming, we were doing the Jedi Council. So I'm sitting there with Sam Jackson to my right, and Yoda to my left, Frank Oz underneath the stage, manipulating the puppet. It was my first day. So it was incredible. Yeah.
Do you have maybe some nice memory from the Star Wars set for me? Maybe some weird things happen, some funny things, some crazy things?
I can't really think of funny, crazy things. I mean, the strange thing about doing it is that for us, it's just a normal movie set. So it's, you know, like, it's every day at work. Which is kind of bizarre if you think about how the fans receive it, you know, as this magical world. For us, we're just sitting around doing our work. I think that's the strangest thing. Yeah.
And getting all these prosthetics on, so how long does it take?
Yeah, that was tough. Ki Adi Mundi was about 4.5 hours to put on. So they glued these various different bits on, the head first. And then once they've glued it, they paint all around the eyes and the lips. So yeah, about 4.5 hours. So, and about 1.5 hours to take off. And with a 12-hour filming day, that makes the whole day about something in the region of 17, 18 hours long. So the days that we were filming back-to-back, Ki Adi Mundi, I didn't get a lot of sleep.
And if we're looking at all this, temperatures as a set from the troopers and so on, does it all fit together, or did maybe some things fell off, like some guys had on Guardians of the Galaxy, that they told me that some things go off because of the temperatures?
No, it was amazing. With Ki Adi, I mean, very, very high-tech prosthetic. So, you know, it glues on and it stayed there all day long, but it moves with the skin and your skin can breathe through it. So after a while, you forget that you're wearing it. The strangest thing for me is that there were lots of people that I worked with who never saw me as Silas. They only ever saw me as Ki Adi. We'd be having conversations, like me and Frank Oz having conversations, you know, Silas to Frank, but he doesn't know what I look like, and I have to carry a photograph around and say, this is what I really look like.
Okay, so at the rap party, maybe people told you, who are you?
That happened a few times. Yeah, it happened a few times.
And my last question, did you get something from the set for yourself?
No.
Maybe steal something? Or?
Oh, God, no. No, 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 no. They were very strict about that. The lightsabers, just the handles that were clipped to our belts, they would bring along in a little box. Just before they shout action, they'd give you the lightsaber, you clip it onto your box. And when I shout cut, they come back with the box, take the lightsaber, put it in it. No, they were very strict. Couldn't take anything from there. Apart from good memories.
Thank you so much.
Very welcome.